Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lyco Birds with another video in my Bird ID Through the Year series, and this one is going to cover common winter ducks. And I'll say up front that the species that would be common near you is highly dependent on exactly where you are. So these are species that are very common and very reliable right in my immediate area, but to some extent, it doesn't really matter because this video is more of an introduction to duck concepts, and there's going to be plenty more videos over the next 2 months that really cover all the duck species that you would find in the East. I'll start with mallard, and I'm not going to spend very much time on the males because I think they're one of the most recognizable species of any type of bird in the world, but I do want to point out a couple of things. So first of all, they have these curly tail feathers, which I will use in reference to something else in a couple minutes, so just keep that in mind. And then I did want to point out a lot of ducks will have sort of brightly colored feathers in this area. And this is called the speculum sometimes when you're referring to waterfowl. And in general, we would call these secondaries. So we have these flight feathers here that are the primary way that birds create lift when they're flying. You have the outer ones here are called primaries, and the inner ones are called secondaries. And on mallards, you have kind of a purple or blue color in the middle, and then you have bold white borders to the front and rear. So that's something that you want to keep in mind for those in flight. And jumping to female mallard, we can actually see this exact same pattern on the wing on the females too, so the males and the females are the same in that regard. But you can see overall the plumage is very different between the males and the females. The females are overall just kind of brown. They have a dark line through the eye. The bill, instead of being yellow, is kind of orangey and has a variable amount of kind of dusky or dark, just messy patching on the bill. And it's quite variable from individual to individual. They also have orange legs. And female mallards are sort of the basis of comparison for all of the drab ducks, which largely is going to be the female plumages. So it's one that you want to learn pretty well. They're fairly large compared to most duck species, and they're very common, so you get to see them a lot. So you get a lot of practice identifying mallards compared to a lot of other species. So a lot of times you can actually even use them in direct comparison to something else to help narrow down your ID. And for an example of what I mean, let's go to American black duck. Now, the males and the females are actually pretty similar to each other in this species, and both of them look sort of similar to female mallards, but they are quite a bit darker. The males have yellow bills, so you can see this is a male and this is a male, and the females have more of like an olive color. So you can see that's a pretty typical color for a female American black duck. Their tails are dark and they don't have the curl that you saw on male mallards. And they also don't have any white in the speculum or the secondaries. So you can see on the open wing here, there's no white border in front of and to the rear of that purple color. And this one here is actually standing in the midst of some mallards. So you can see here's a female mallard to compare with it, and you can see just how much darker they are compared to female mallards. But otherwise, they look fairly similar. And in flight, a lot of times you'll see them from underneath. And the thing that really stands out is just how dark the body is in contrast to the white here in the underwing. And something else you have to keep in mind with these two species is hybridization. There's actually a lot of mallard contamination that makes it into the American black duck gene pool. And you can see this is an example of a typical hybrid between American black duck and mallard. This, of course, would be a male, but you can see the body largely is dark like an American black duck, but it's got this half green head, which is the mallard influence. But sometimes the influence is not that obvious. So if we look at this bird, this looks like a pretty normal male American black duck. But if we zoom in on the tail, you can see a couple of these feathers look a little bit curly. So that probably suggests that there's at least a little bit of mallard in this bird. And it's definitely not a first generation hybrid. It's probably a back cross over several generations. And is anybody going to yell at you if you call this an American black duck? Probably not, but it's just one of the complicating factors with these. So let's move on to our first diving duck. So mallards and American black ducks are what are called dabbling ducks. And for the most part, they are going to stay on the surface, maybe dip their head underwater to feed. And they can also come up on shore and walk pretty easily. Well, most diving ducks are not going to be able to do that, and they tend to hang out in deeper water, kind of farther away from the shore, and you'll see them dive completely under the water pretty regularly. So this is Bufflehead, and this is one of the main species that I find on the river near where I live. And the males have a lot of white on the body with black on the back, and they've got this dark head with this big white patch that starts behind the eye and goes all the way around the back of the head. The females, you can see structurally, very similar, but they are all dark, and then they just have this little white ear patch. They also have some white when you see the open wing. And the other species of duck that I commonly find on the river is common merganser. And these are a little bit different from typical ducks with the shape of their bill. Their bill is actually quite thin and long compared to most ducks that, you know, have a fairly flat bill, what you typically think of as a duck bill. But there are three species of merganser that we get in North America, and they all have fairly similar bills to this that are different from the other ducks. And this is what male common mergansers look like. They have largely white bodies with dark on the back. They have dark heads that can look either kind of like a black or glossy black, or depending on the lighting, can also look green. And then you have the females, which you can see compared to these males, are very similar shape, all of them fairly long bodied, and they have those thin bills. The females, though, are gray, with kind of a reddish brown head, and also they have a white patch in the chin. And I think that's a pretty good introduction to the ducks. So we looked at two dabbling ducks, a diving duck, and a merganser. We are going to definitely expand upon that and cover all of the species that you would expect during the coming 2 months or so. Waterfowl migration really kicks up in March, kind of continues through April, so that's going to be the prime time that I cover those. There's going to be probably at least 5 or 6 more videos that I do for ducks. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you next time.